The name, the title of this class is, I had a bunch of different titles, right? I was trying to figure out when it was going to fit. But yeah, this is for my single mothers out here, right? Not just for the single mothers, it's for the simps too. The single mothers, the simps, the mama's boys, right? You brothers that let the woman run the household and tell you what to do, right? That's what that class is about. A lot of you weak, effeminate men, this is the way it happened, right? So the title of this class is Mama's Boys and the Mothers That Made Them. Mama's Boys and the Mothers That Made Them, right? Because you weren't born. If you're a mama's boy and you listen to this, you know if you're a mama's boy. It is what it is. I used to be a mama's boy. It is what it is. My mom, she run the household when I was growing up. She still do, right? So guess what? You know if you're a mama's boy or not. So if you're a mama's boy, hey, listen to the class. But this mostly going out to you, sister, because guess what? Mama's boys, they ain't born that way. They created, right? They are raised. They are turned into mama's boys, right? That's not our regular original nature right there, right? So we're going to talk about this, right? And so I had a title. I wanted to call it covert incest, right? Because guess what? Incest is one of them things that we don't like to talk about. Matter of fact, give me that definition of taboo real quick. Give me a definition of taboo. Because we got a lot of this in the black family. Y'all ever hear it in the black family where they go, you got a lot of brothers and cousins who really ain't brothers and cousins. You got a lot of play cousins or play brothers. You got uncle this or whatever. There's a lot of that in the black community because guess what? Just the same principle as to why people don't want to come into bodies and be inside a camp, it's the same thing as why we got a lot of things in our communities that we don't talk about. Because we want to hide it. We want to stay in that sin. We don't want nobody to know about our sin. You come into a body, we're going to know if you smoke. You come into the body, we're going to know if you like to wear blonde hair. If you come into the body and you're a homosexual, guess what? That spirit going to reveal itself. We're going to see it, right? And that's what goes on in the black community, right? Read that definition of a taboo.
Taboo. Essential.
Matter of fact, drop down. It should be a noun in there. It should go down to the noun part. Yeah, read that. Read the noun definition.
Taboo. Definition 1A, a prohibition imposed by social custom.
So a prohibition is when you're trying to stop something. Like they talk about prohibition dealing with alcohol. Back in the day, guess what? They did prohibition to stop selling alcohol, right? So this talking about a prohibition imposed by social customs. Guess what? I don't know too much about the other tribes, but I know Judah. One thing I know about Judah is that, like, don't talk about our business. If something going on in the house, it stay in the house. Don't talk about our business, right? That's a social custom. That's a custom of Judah. I'm pretty sure it's all Israel get down like this. But for sure, Judah, your mom would be like, don't you talk about nothing that go in this house, right? Read.
A prohibition imposed by social custom or as a protective measure.
As a protective measure. Measure, right? What you think be trying to be protected in the black household, right? What was that movie that Deacon Abiel put up, that little show, The Secret of, what was that? Some household, you know, it was like 30 minutes. The what? The Secret of the Johnson Family, right? Right? That go on a lot in Israel. That's we watched that little show and we like, man, that's going on. But guess what? That stuff happened, right? And it's done to do what? To protective measures, to keep the father out of jail, to keep the mom out of jail, to keep the uncle out of jail, right? To keep their name together. Like, I don't want nobody to think that, you know, this stuff going on in our household, right? That's taboo. Keep reading.
B, something that is not acceptable to say, mention, or do. Something that is taboo.
Go to verse, let's see, what's that? Number the two. Second one? Yeah, number two.
A prohibition against touching, saying, or doing something for fear of immediate harm from a supernatural force.
All right, so taboo. So incest is something we don't like to talk about. We don't like to talk about, you know, which, but it's in the Bible. Anything that's in the Bible, guess what? Guess what? We do it. We got it going on. It's happening in our households if it's in the Bible, right? So let's see. Let's get to that definition. Let's get to the definition of, let's see what I want. What I want. Let's go to covert incest.
Covert incest, also known as emotional incest.
So covert incest are also known as emotional incest, right? So we're about to deal with some stuff that deal with the emotions, right? We talk about a mama's boy. Guess what you first think about? You think of that. Oh, he emotional. You emotional, bruh. You emotional. Like, we say that all the time, right? We were made emotional. By who? By our mothers, right? Read that.
Is a type of abuse in which a parent looks to their child for emotional support.
It says it's a type of abuse. That's something you got to think about, this thing, right? What we about to go in today, it's abusive, right? It's abuse that's going on in our households dealing with the mothers and the relationship with their sons. It's abusive, right?
That would be normally provided by another adult.
Read.
The effects of covert incest on children when they become adults are thought to mimic actual incest.
It says, so what? Guess what? Even though it's not physical incest, right? It's not a father actually having sex with the daughter or a mother having sex with the son. Even though it's not actual physical incest, guess what? The results of that thing, it mimics actual incest, right? That's something we got to think about. That means what we about to go over today, even though it ain't no touching and rubbing going on, right? The results are the same. It's going to be the same mental results. Keep reading.
Although to a lesser degree, this term describes interaction between a parent and child that are exclusive of sexual abuse.
That are exclusive of sexual abuse. So it's certain things you can do. Like they say, what's that term? They say sticks and stones will break my bones, but words will never harm me. Guess what? That ain't true.
Nope.
That ain't true. These words and things that's being said, guess what? They can harm you. They can stay on you forever, for the rest of your life. And we're going to show that. We're going to show how this form of incest starts off young, right? The middle of their life, and it follows you all the way through, and it'll make you who you are. It'll make you the man who you are, right? Let's see. I think I got, what's that other one? There's another one that had covert incest. You pulled it up earlier. The other one with covert incest. Let's see. Drop, keep going down. Let's see. All right, we're going to read some of these points. Let's see. It says examples of covert incest. Let's go through some of these examples real quick.
Examples of covert incest. The following examples come from anecdotal reports from people who have experienced covert incest. A parent or caregiver may be engaged in this behavior if they rely on a child for support.
Read. Keep reading.
They may include confiding in them about their relationship problems, looking to them for comfort or reassurance, or asking the child for advice that is inappropriate for their age.
Now, we know these things go on right here. A lot of times, moms, guess what? Moms, they keep their sons in their business, right? They ask them different things, like, what you think about that? What you think about this? Certain things like that, guess what? That's not where it's supposed to be, right? It says, what that first definition, go back to that first definition real quick, because it says it's a type of abuse which a parent looks to their child for emotional support that would normally be provided by another adult, right? By another adult. Let me show you some stuff that's supposed to be provided dealing with our mothers, different things that should be provided from our mothers. Let's start from the beginning. Let's start off at Genesis. Genesis 3 and verse 16. Let's start off with some things, right, that women should be going to another adult for. Read that scripture.
Genesis chapter 3 and verse 16.
Go ahead.
Unto the woman he said, I will greatly multiply thy sorrow and thy conception. In sorrow thou shalt bring forth children, And thy desire shall be to thy husband.
Wait, the desire should be to thy son.
And thy desire shall be to thy husband.
The desire should be to their husband, right? That means what the things that they think about, that they if they want something, right? Guess where they should go for those things? They should go to their husband, right? The things that they feel they should be doing, taking care of, guess where they should get that from? They should get it from their husbands, not from their sons, not from their kids. And that's what happens a lot of times in our communities, right? Guess what? The woman, she starts living for who? For her son, right? Sometimes women be like, that's my little boyfriend right there. A lot of these women, they dress their kids up just like them, right? They go out in matching outfits and stuff like that. A lot of these women dress their kids up like the men that left them there, right? They desire is to their sons, right, and not to their husbands. It's supposed to be to their husbands, right? That's where the desire should come from. But what happens is you got these women, we see it all the time. If you watch, if you ever watch Kevin Samuels or anybody on the, what they call that part of the internet, blue pill, red pill, or something like that, the manosphere, that's what they call it. If you ever watch any of those videos on the manosphere, right, you understand that women, single mothers, right, they instead of them trying to concentrate on getting married to a man, what they concentrate on is taking care of their kid. They don't see the need for a man in the household, right? They got their man. That's their son. So now they need to do what? Get a job, get a PhD, do this, do that, right? They worried about them and their son, and they not worried about getting a husband. That's why their desire is messed up. Go to Psalms chapter 82. Psalms 82, let's start at verse 1. Because that's the reason why everything's messed up like it is. The foundation started with what? Adam, Eve, man, woman having kids, right? That was the foundation from the beginning. But what happened is through our sin, all that changed. Read that. Psalms 82, start at verse 1. Read down to 5.
Psalm chapter 82 and verse 1.
Go ahead.
God standeth in the congregation of the mighty. He judgeth among the gods.
I like that right there. He said he judge among the gods. Black man, you're a god on this earth. That's Hispanic right. Man, you're a god. All 12 tribes, you brothers, you are gods on this earth. You ain't
That's
no
right.
Negroes. You ain't no Haitians. You ain't black. You are God on earth. Read.
How long will ye judge unjustly?
Read.
And accept the persons of the wicked? Selah. Defend the poor and fatherless.
It says do what?
Defend the poor and fatherless.
The Most High God is going to defend the poor and the fatherless. That's why he sent the prophets out. Guess what we're trying to do? We're trying to defend the poor and the fatherless. Read.
Do justice to the afflicted and needy.
Go ahead.
Deliver the poor and needy. Rid them out of the hand of the wicked.
Rid them out of the hand of the wicked. Because it's a wicked thing to raise your kids out of order. It's a wicked thing to engage in covert incest. It's a wicked thing to do that. Go ahead.
They know not, neither will they understand.
Guess what? Y'all know not, but if you listen today, you're going to understand today. Read.
They walk on in darkness.
Go ahead.
All the foundations of the earth are out of course.
That's what I wanted right there. Read that last part again.
All the foundations of the earth are out of course.
All the foundations of the earth are out of course. That's why our households are messed up, right? Because you got women not wanting to get married. They haven't. First of all, you got the whole just being a single mother to begin with. You got brothers and sisters having sex before they get married. They having kids that they don't want. The man leave or the woman chase the man away. And guess what? She forced to have to raise this kid by herself. You know how she going to do it? She ain't going to do it right. She going to do it out of order. She going to do it out of course. That's why our world is out of course right now. Right? So let's go back. Let's see where we at right now. Let's go to 1 Corinthians chapter 11 and verse 3. 1 Corinthians 11 and verse 3.
1 Corinthians chapter 11 and verse 3.
Go ahead.
But I would have you know that the head of every man is Christ.
Go ahead.
And the head of the woman is the man.
And the head of the woman is the man, right? If the head of the woman is not her kid. Right. If you do that post, if we can look it up all over YouTube, every once in a while, I'll see that post that say, who he first, the husband or the kid, the husband or the kid, who he first. Only black people got to make posts like that. Right. White people don't make posts like that because right. They already know the business. They know the deal. You think the A-Rab man got to make a post, who he first, me or my kids? You out of your mind, right? But guess what? Since the foundation of the earth, of the our world, is turned upside down, we got to have engaged in silly posts like this, where they like, my kid going to eat first. I don't care about no man. It's about me and my kid. Me and my kid going to eat first. I'm like, but they all sitting at the table at the same time. It's not like you're going to give the you're going to get a plate to your husband. He's going to sit there. He's going to eat all his food. And after he finished, then you're going to give it to the kid. You're talking about 10 seconds. But guess what? That 10 seconds is enough to bring out that feminism, right? To bring all that hatred that feminism have given to our sisters against our men, to keep that role so they can keep that preeminence, right? That's what they want. They keep that preeminence. Put the man out the way, right? Where we at?
Verse 3.
Read it.
And the head of the woman is the man.
And the head of the woman is the man. So we got an order. You got God, Christ, man, woman, and then you got the kids under there, right? Matter of fact, go to Titus 2 to make sure we break it down all the way to where the kids at. Because like I said, if somebody said, make sure it's in the Bible, right?
Titus chapter 2 and verse 3. The aged woman likewise, that they be in behavior as becometh holiness.
Great.
Not false accusers.
Go ahead.
Not given to much wine.
Go ahead.
Teachers of good things, that they may teach the young women to be sober, to love their husbands, to love their children.
To do what?
To love their children.
And that's where it comes. That's the teacher. That's the teaching stages that's going on right there, right? You got God teaching Christ. You got Christ teaching the man. You got the man teaching the woman. You got the woman dealing with the children. And guess what? She dealing with the children according to how her husband wants her to deal with the children. She ain't detached and she go and do her own thing and teach her own lessons. No, it's the way the head of that household want those things to happen. But when you're a single mother, right? And look, a lot of times, a lot of these single mothers, it ain't their fault, right? Because guess what? You got wicked brothers. You got wicked Negroes that's out there. What they say, mama's baby, daddy's maybe. Right? Papa was a rolling stone. We got all those things. We know that go on in our community, right? But when it happens, guess what? It's got to be some kind of education or some learning or something to deal with. How do you deal with that, right? Because a lot of women, I don't think you know the drama, the pain, the emotional damage that you cause when these things, when you do these certain things, right? So it's already an order right there. The order that's it's out of place, is out of line, right? Go to 1 Timothy chapter 5 and verse 8. 1 Timothy 5 and verse 8.
1 Timothy chapter 5 and verse 8.
Go ahead.
But if any provide not for his own, and especially for those of his own house, he hath denied the faith.
So guess what? A man is supposed to provide for his household. But what happens is, guess what happens? It's not a man there. So what the scriptures, what that definition said, she go to somebody else for that support, right? How many of y'all, I'm just going to say it. I know for a fact when I was young, when I had a job, guess what? I had to give some money to the household, right? And it wasn't because we was poor and we needed. It was because my parents, they lived a life that wasn't right. They was at the casinos, stuff like that. And guess what? They'd come to me, hey, you know, how about you just keep $75 of your check and give us the rest, you know. I ain't had nowhere to go. I was young. I had to do it. It is what it is. So I was giving that up, right? But a lot of times with single mothers, which we're going to see later on with some of the videos we're going to show, you're going to see that some of these single mothers, they're going to depend on their kids for how to live. They're going to depend on that thing. They're going to depend on the jobs of these kids. They're going to depend on, they're going to push them into certain things, right? They're going to do that kind of stuff, all right? Keep reading that scripture.
And it's worse than an infidel.
And it's what?
And it's worse than an infidel.
So guess what? A man is supposed to provide for that household. But when there's no man in a household, we deal with this covert incest, guess what happens? They start to do what? They start to depend on their sons to do this thing. You had something?
Yes, sir. And you know, that happened a lot during like the middle 80s and in the 90s, because when that drug epidemic hit our neighborhoods real hard, you have single mothers who raising teenagers, and these brothers going out selling drugs, doing whatever they had to do to take care of their mothers, and they had to depend on that thing, right? And so let me get one script real quick. Let me get Sirach 30 and verse 11. Sirach 30 and verse 11. Because during that time, they had to depend on their sons for support, depend on their sons to help them out.
Ecclesiasticus chapter 30 and verse 11. Give him no liberty in his youth, and wink not at his follies.
So that's what they had to do. They know they out there selling drugs, out there doing bad, but they wink at the follies that they was doing. And they emotionally scarred them brothers. Now they got to be out there being angry, having to put on their face because they got to defend their mother. And their mother got to depend on them. So that happened a lot in our communities with the son supporting the mother.
Hey, it don't always end with that, right? Because guess what? A lot of these single mothers, they don't just depend on their kids, but they also depend on what? Government assistance, right? They depend on that government assistance. Some of these women, now I ain't saying all women do this, but some women have kids so they can do what? Get more money, right? So they can get more money from some of these government assistance. Some of y'all be like, nah, that ain't true. That is true. I know for a fact that that is true, that women do that thing. They depend on their kids for that. They push their kids to certain careers, right? And just like how he said, they okay. Some mothers are okay with the selling the drugs, right? What was that show? The Wire. Remember The Wire with Lil Naaman? His dad went to jail, and Lil Naaman was out there. And his mom was like, look, cut your hair. You got to be out there on the block selling this dope and this, that, this, and that. While she was in the house, what, buying the red bottoms, things like that, having the expensive coats and jewelry and things like that. She wanted her son to go out there in the streets and sell drugs, right? And if you watch that show, you'll see how she emotionally damaged him, right? He really wasn't a dumb kid, but he was in school acting like he was dumb. He was acting like he was the baddest. He was acting like all those different things. And then next you know, he ended up crying and ended up going and staying with somebody else that had a man in the household, excuse me, that was going to raise him the right way. Right? I don't know what that was. I don't know what that was like. It's crazy. Right? But that's what went on. That's what goes on. That covert incest, it does those things like that. Right? Go to 1 Peter chapter 3, verse 7. Right? It says let me read that definition again. It says a type of abuse in which a parent looks to their child for emotional support that would normally provided by another adult. Read that.
1 Peter chapter 3 and verse 7.
Go ahead.
Likewise, ye husbands, dwell with them according to knowledge.
Go ahead.
Giving honor unto the wife as unto the weaker vessel.
The wife is the what?
Weaker vessel.
The what?
Weaker vessel.
The wife is the weaker vessel. The weaker vessel, right? And that's not just I got more muscles than you. They got some big sisters out here. They got some sisters out here that's strong. You know what I'm saying? They got some sisters that throw. I watched a video where his sister was dragging a man around the street. This little skinny guy. I don't know why y'all little skinny guys like women bigger than y'all. I don't get it. You know what I'm saying? But but y'all do. And you get out of line, guess what? Bah, bah, bah. You getting drugged down the street looking crazy, right? But the scripture says that the woman is the weaker vessel, right? So it ain't just physically weaker, but guess what? It's emotionally weaker, right? She emotionally weaker, right? When it comes to that weakness, a lot of times the women, they like we say, we do our things out of course, right? A lot of times these women, they think they the boss, right? They want to be the boss. They want to be in charge. They want to do this and that. Guess what? Their husband is the one that does what? Lets her know, you ain't the boss, right? You need to be in this submissive, feminine, not feminist, but feminine state, right? If she ain't got no husband, then guess what? She feel like she got to fit that role, right? For Father's Day, they up there, you got pictures of women, happy Father's Day to me. You know, like, something ain't right. Something ain't right about that.
I'm a mama and a daddy.
They the what?
On the mama and the daddy.
The mama and the daddy. Hey, somebody wrote on here, if she isn't fluffy, she's boring. Hey, y'all crazy. Y'all crazy. Shout out to the fluffy sisters out there. Most High Christ bless. Just don't beat your skinny husbands up. I'll praise the Lord Most High. Read that 1 Peter 3, man. Y'all crazy. Read that 1 Peter 3 and verse 7 again.
1 Peter chapter 3 and verse 7.
Go ahead.
Likewise, ye husbands, dwell with them according to knowledge.
Go ahead.
Giving honor unto the wife as unto the weaker vessel.
As the weaker vessel. The weaker vessel. So guess what? If you brought up under your mom taking care of you, and she's the weaker vessel, what kind of traits you think you're going to pick up? You're going to pick up weak traits, right? You're going to pick up weak traits. A man should be able to say, my emotional side is at home right now getting dinner ready. Nah, they be like, hey, you need to dip into your emotional side. I marry my emotional side. That's where the emotional side at, right? But if you're a single mother, you push your emotional side on that kid. You may not know you're doing it, but guess what? You're doing it, right? Go to 1 Corinthians chapter 12. Start at verse 20. 1 Corinthians chapter 12. I think that's what I want. Let me look at it real quick. 12 and verse 20.
1 Corinthians chapter 12 and verse 20.
Go ahead.
But now are they many members, yet but one body.
It's many members, but one body. Just even dealing with a household, right? You can have many members in that household, but it's got to be done one way. The only way is that is according to the Bible. Read.
Verse 21.
Go ahead.
And the eye cannot say unto the hand,
read,
I have no need of thee.
Go ahead.
Nor again the head to the feet, I have no need of you. Nay, much more those members of the body which seem to be more feeble.
Members of the body that seem to be what?
More feeble.
More feeble, right? What's that feebleness? What we just talked about, right? Talking about the women being the weaker vessel, right? Because I'm not saying, hey, y'all women, y'all weak, we don't need y'all. Hey, look, what they say, can't live with them? Can't live without them, right? I don't know what we do without, well, whatever. Can't live with them, can't live without them. I ain't say nothing. You know, no face, no case. Read that again.
Verse 22.
Go ahead.
Nay, much more those members of the body, which seem to be more feeble.
They seem to be more feeble, right?
Are necessary.
They are necessary, right? They are necessary. Women are necessary. Even though they feeble, they necessary, right? And a lot of times dealing with this, a lot of times women, they take the kids' accomplishments to make them feel good, right? A real woman, let me show you something about a real woman. Go to Proverbs 31. A real woman don't need her kids' accomplishments to make her feel special, right? I'm going to show you what she care about. We just read about it earlier in Genesis 3. I'm going to show you something. Proverbs 31 and verse, hold on, let me see what I want. Proverbs 31 and verse 31.
Proverbs chapter 31 and verse 31.
Go ahead.
Give her of the fruit of her hands.
Read.
And let her own works praise her in the gates.
Guess what? Her own works is what's going to praise her and make her feel special, right? But guess what? When you read Proverbs 31, them own works ain't going into getting a PhD, right? Being a super nurse that's making thousands of dollars all over. Guess what? Her works, all in Proverbs 31, deal with her taking care of her husband first, taking care of the household, the kids, right? That's what it go into, right? But a lot of these women, they'll take their kids' accomplishments and make them theirs, right? They live through their kids. They live through their sons, right? It's like, hey, I want you to be a lawyer. You're like, okay, but I don't want to be a lawyer. I want to be a doctor. Nah, I always wanted to be a lawyer. I want you to be a lawyer, right? That I want you to play basketball. You make a lot of money playing basketball, and then I can go sit sidelines or in the women's section and things like that, and I could be one of these basketball wives that I watch on TV all the time, right? So let's where we at? Where I'm at? Let me make sure. Let's see. 1 Corinthians 14:35.
1 Corinthians chapter 14 and verse 35.
Go ahead.
And if they will learn anything, let them ask their husbands at home.
If they shall learn anything, they shall ask their husbands at home. Husbands at home, right? Women, they supposed to be a reflection of their husbands, right? They supposed to be a reflection of their husbands, right? You got a righteous husband, more like the sister, she going to be righteous too. More than likely, if he teaching, doing things like that, they're going to be that reflection. The husband about God's law, statutes, and commandments, right? He doing what he's supposed to do in the household, is going to reflect, go to the wife, and it's going to be taught to the kids, right? But that's not a lot of times where the, what can I say? How can I say this? A lot of times these women think they still 17 years old, right? You have an older woman. She like 40 years old. She walking around with tights on, right? She got a FUBU shirt on, right? She got some
got blue hair.
Blue, yellow, green, pink hair, things like that, right? Because she still want to be young, right? If you guess what, let me see what I want. Go to Ciroc. Give me that about the hedge. Where we at? Where we at? What I want.
Ciroc, the book of Ecclesiasticus, chapter 36 and verse 25.
Go ahead.
Where no hedge is, there the possession.
Matter of fact, we talked about, Bishop Kanaan talked about this this Sabbath. Start at verse 24.
Verse 24.
Go ahead.
He that getteth a wife beginneth a possession.
Beginneth a possession, right? Right? Don't mean you get a possession. You begin a possession. You begin a way to start building your household righteously, right? So you're going to, guess what? You're going to teach that weaker vessel. You're going to show her what's right. You ain't going to let your, a real man ain't going to let his wife get blue hair. It just is what it is, right? She 40 years old looking like Smurfette or something like that, right? Nah, you ain't about to do that. Like, look, rainbow color hair, green, aqua, whatever. What'd you say? Damn cumbrellas. Some of y'all brothers be letting y'all wife walk around looking like Snuffleupagus.
Weave down to the flow.
Hey, I love what they say. The sisters got their weave all the way down to their ankles. You know what I'm saying? They trying to be young. They want to be kids still, right? Nah. They need that hedge of protection. Read that. Verse 25. Yeah, finish 24.
A help like unto himself.
Go ahead.
And a pillar of rest.
Rest. Read.
Where no hedge is, there the possession is spoiled.
If you, if women, if you don't have a hedge, guess what? You're going to be spoiled, right? You're not going to understand how to raise that son. You're not going to understand what's appropriate, what's not appropriate. You ain't going to have somebody to say, what's wrong with you, woman? You can't do that. The little boy want to walk around and put heels on and y'all all laughing. Hey, when the husband walk in the house, I will be, don't be throw a dang old candle at you. Hit you with a book or something. I don't know. But that hedge is that protection, right? That's the thing that's going to protect you from doing what? For being that weaker vessel, right? From teaching the son to be emotional. The husband's going to be like, hey, this and that, this and that, right? I can remember because, you know, I'm a stepfather. I can remember this thing. I can remember my son, right? I think he was like maybe 3 years old, something like that, 4 years old. I don't know how old he was, but he was young, right? And then we was throwing a ball back and forth at each other. And I threw the ball. And it hit him, and he fell on the ground. And his mom, when she was about to go, I turned around, I said, I didn't really say nothing. I just gave her that, you know, that father, that man, leave him alone, right? And I said, hey, get up. Ain't nothing wrong with you. He was about to cry. But guess what he did? He hopped back up. I said, dust yourself off, right? And I started throwing the ball at him even harder. Just started hit him even harder. Like, you're going to get you out of that. You ain't going to be no mama's boy around me. That's man up. That's right. That's that hedge of protection that a husband is going to give. It's that you're going to have a hedge of protection. He ain't going to let you be spoiled. He going to see certain stuff. A real man anyway, going to see certain stuff. And he's going to be like, nah, that ain't about to happen up in here. Right. That's that protection that we're going to get. Right. All right. So go back to the let me see. Let's see what I'm trying to look at now. Let's see. Go to that article, the one that said Medical News Today. The Medical News Today article. Go to that article real quick. I think that's what I want. You found that for me, DJ Abishak? Matter of fact, I heard we got the commercial. Let's go to a commercial break real quick. Let's bring up that commercial break real quick that we were supposed to get earlier. All praises to the Most High. All right, we back. So guess what we about to do? Well, matter of fact, remember this. The title of this right here. Covert Mama's Boys and the Mothers That Made Them. Right? We talking about covert incest. And dealing with that escaping. As a matter of fact, given that scripture, did we read that yet? Did we read Psalm 71? Let's read Psalm 71. I'm trying to keep it in the same vein. Dealing with IUIC Mississippi. Dealing with the same vein, IUIC Mississippi. Let's go. Read that one time.
Psalms chapter 71 and verse 2.
Go ahead.
Deliver me in thy righteousness.
That's what we're trying to do. We're trying to deliver our people into God's righteousness. Read.
And cause me to escape.
To do what?
To escape.
Right now we're trying to get you. Look, you sing some of you single mothers. That mindset that you got on how you should raise your kids, guess what you got to do? You got to escape from that thing. You got to escape. You got to get away from it. The world is telling you this is the way to do it, but God's law, statutes, and commandments, they differ. It ain't about that no more. You got to escape from that mindset and be renewed. Read.
Incline thine ear unto me and save me.
All praises to the Most High. So guess what we're about? We're trying to escape, get our people off the plantation, escape this plantation. It's a lot of mental things that we still holding on to. I know when I used to work retail, guess what? Esau used to walk in or the other nations walk in, I wanted to give them a discount. I don't know why I wanted to give them a discount. I just did. You know, I was nicer to them and stuff like that. But then when my people walked in, I'd be like, I bet they're going to want some kind of discount. Look, I bet you. Watch.
Want the hook right? Up.
They want the hookup. Look, I want the hookup, right? I don't know why I was like that. But guess what? My mind was in the plantation. My mind was on the plantation. It was picking cotton. Yes, sir, boss. We sick today. That's where a lot of our minds are. A lot of our sisters, y'all mind in the plantation right now. Right? We're trying to get you out the plantation, all right? So let's see what we're going to do. Let me see. Let me look at these videos. Let's see where I want to go. Let's see. Okay, go to that Medical News Today article real quick. That Medical News Today article. Pull that up. It should talk about covert incest. Gonna be that picture of the shadows. That is what I want. All right, go back to that examples of covert incest, right? It's gonna be down here. Some of these examples, right? Read that. Let's just read these examples again.
The following examples come from anecdotal reports from people who have experienced covert incest. A parent or caregiver may be engaged in this behavior if they rely on a child for support. This may include confiding in them about their relationship problems, looking to them for comfort or reassurance, or asking the child for advice that is inappropriate for their age.
All right, let's go to the next one.
Put their needs before the child's. The caregiver may expect frequent praise and affection from the child or wish to feel that they are the most important thing in the child's life.
Man, a lot of you mama's boys, y'all know about this. Where your mom want to feel like she the most important thing in your life, right? How many married brothers today, right? Let's think about this thing. Y'all married, but for some reason, your mom don't like your wife. She don't like your wife. She like your ex-girlfriend. She like the sister you used to deal with, right? And guess what? If you was to leave the sister you with right now and get another sister, guess what? She ain't gonna like that sister. She gonna like the ex. That's what they do, right? They do those different things that happen, that go on in our communities, right? Because it says, the affection from a trial, or wish to feel that they are the most important thing in the child's life. That's why the mom, she don't ever like, I ain't saying never. But that happens in our communities, right? Your mom don't like your wife. For what? Well, she said this. Or she should have said, she's supposed to apologize to me for that. Or she brought potato salad, and she knew I was cooking the potato salad. Always something stupid. Some reason. But that don't have nothing to do with it. She wants your love and your love only. She wants her son. She wants to be the most important thing and her son's life, right?
They view the wife as a threat.
It's a threat.
A threat to them or something.
Say that again.
They view the wife as a threat to their love for you or to their spot or something like that. So that's why they never liked the wife or the one that you with at that time.
And they go, look, they go all the way against the scriptures. Go to Matthew chapter 19 real quick. Matthew 19, start at verse 5. Matthew 19 and 5.
Matthew right. chapter 19 and verse 5.
Go ahead.
And said, for this cause shall a man leave father and mother.
Should do what?
Shall a man leave father and mother.
Guess what, brothers? You got to leave your father and your mother, right? You ain't no man. If you still living with your mom and dad, you got your wife up in there, you got your kids on in there, you ain't a man. It says that a real man is going to leave who? He going to leave his mom? Keep reading it again.
For this cause shall a man leave father and mother.
You're going to leave your father and your mother if you a real man according to the Bible, right? But if you're a mama's boy, you're okay with coming into the house, you know what I'm saying? You got to be quiet when y'all trying to get it in. Or whatnot, right? You up there done put your iced coffee in the refrigerator, and your dad done picked it up. He drinking it out the bottle. You know what I'm saying? How you gonna be a man in that household under God's law, statutes, and commandments? It's a Sabbath day. Guess what? Your mom in there cooking grits, baking grease all over the place. Come on now, read that scripture again.
Said. For this cause shall a man leave father and mother.
You got to leave your father and mother. Sisters, listen, understand this, sisters. Your job, if you are a single mother, right, and you not, and you don't have a husband yet, your job is to raise your son so he is prepared to, when he find a wife, to leave you. To leave you. Not still be living in the house. Not, that's going to, you my baby. Don't say, sister, stop saying that. You gonna always be my baby. No, they not. That ain't your baby.
20 years old.
He ain't 20 years. That ain't your baby. That's a man. Right? He ain't your baby. He probably got babies.
Boy, ain't no way, boy.
You gonna know that's gonna always be my baby. You gonna always be. No, he a man. You should want your son to be a man so he won't do to another woman what his dad did to you. But guess what? Y'all don't do that. Because y'all don't think about yourselves. And you selfish, so you raise your kids just like the men that didn't want to be with you. And you all wonder what's wrong. Give me that in Isaiah, Isaiah 3? Isaiah 3 and verse 12. Sisters be talking about some, man, N ain't S. These brothers ain't S. These brothers ain't S, right? But y'all the ones raising these brothers. But they ain't nothing. Know why? Because you ain't raising them the way you're supposed to be raising them. You raising them to be emotional. Right? You care about your job. You care about your career. You care about getting that PhD, getting your master's, getting your graduate degree. And you ain't worried about what do I need to do so I can get a husband for my son so he can be raised like a real man according to the Bible. Right. That ain't in your mind right there. You're like, oh, I can get married when I'm 40. You crazy as hell. Read that scripture.
Isaiah chapter 3 and verse 12.
Go ahead.
As for my people, children are their oppressors.
Who are their oppressors?
Children. Are their oppressors.
Guess what? Children are the ones that's in these neighborhoods breaking in the cars. Matter of fact, I got an alert the other day from my old neighborhood. They're talking about something. They got kids, six young men dressed the same, breaking into people's cars late at night, right? Children are our oppressors, Reed.
And women rule over them.
Who rule over them?
And women rule over them.
Y'all the ones that's raising the kids. That's why they acting like that, right? Because you got all this incest going on in the house, all this emotional incest, this covert incest that's going on in the house. That's why they're being raised. They're getting raised just like little girls. They're getting raised to be emotional. They're getting raised to not be men. And that's something they got to change right there, right? Let me see. Read that part again. Go back to the article. Go back to the article again. I think it was a video I wanted to bring up real quick. Going to put their needs before the child's.
Examples of covert incest. Put their needs before the child's. The caregiver may expect frequent praise and affection from the child or wish to feel that they are the most important thing in the child's life.
All right, let's go to that. Give me that video I got with the wicked mother-in-law. That's it right here. Let me show you something right here. Let's play this video right here.
Going on here, like why she in the front seat, and I get that that's your mom and everything, but like you go going to the back, right?
No, absolutely not.
Why? What are you talking about?
Hey, hold on, Rick. She's like, why are you in the front seat? You won't go in the back. She's like, no, absolutely not. She's like, I ain't going in the back. I'm sitting in the front because that's my baby that's driving right there. Because I'm the most important thing in my child's life, right? Think about this argument right here. Like, you already know that it's friction between the mother and his wife already, just because of this video, just because they having this argument, this disagreement about who get to sit in the front seat. Hey, look, it is what it is, right? The person sitting in the front seat gonna be who the hell I want to be sitting in the front seat. And if I'm a mama's boy, then guess what? I want my mama sitting in the front seat, right? But guess what? If you're a man, you're like, hey, mama, what you say? If it's a woman that love her son and love the decision that her son made and that wife, guess what she gonna do? She gonna automatically go get in the back seat. She gonna be like, let me hold on. You know, you can sit in the front. You know, you might have to be like, no. And then the daughter be like, no, you go ahead and sit in the front. I know you got bad knees. You go ahead and sit in the front, right? But you know that's not the relationship that they have, right? She don't like his wife, right? And that's why they mad at each other. That's why she rolled up with that attitude. Let's go finish the video right here. Finish that video up.
What's going on here? Like, why she in the front seat?
And if you notice, the brother, like, he's smiling, right? Because he's a kid.
Going to the back, right?
No, absolutely not.
Why? What are you talking about? I'm your wife. Are you serious right now?
Okay,
calm down. We gotta keep having these type of conversations. Every time I link up with your mother, is always a problem.
Hey, wait, pause that. What she said, every time I deal with your mother, it's always a problem. It's always a problem. Hey, look, if you sisters on here, you listening, and you got a son and he married, and every time you deal with his wife, it's a problem. Who's supposed to be the adult? Who the adult? Which one the adult? Who older? Who's supposed to have more wisdom, right? If you up here having arguments with your son, wife, guess what? You out of order. You out of order. And that's what goes on in single parent house, not just a single parent household, but for the most part, it's these single parent households. These mothers act like this, or these mothers that run the house, right? Because if she was married to a real man, he'd be like, hey, look, leave her alone. He'd be like, leave her alone, sit your butt in the back seat and stop causing trouble in Darius's life, right? That's what he gonna say. But guess what? She ain't got no hedge, right? So she wanna be important. She the mama, right? I'm the mama. What? Man, these women crazy. You got something to say? All right, all praises. All right, go back to the video. Let's see. Let's finish it on out. Well, we ain't gonna finish it out because it's long.
Okay, but go to the back fucking seat.
Babe,
I'm your wife. I'm your fucking wife.
And I love you.
This is my car.
Wait, she said that's her car? Because guess what? Hey, he just, hey, why did that thing go? He's just a baby boy. He a baby boy. Pause that. That's not even his car. That's her car. That's her car, because you know why? Because he a baby boy. He a mama's boy, right? He probably drop her off at work and then go ride around all day and bang her friends. He a baby's boy. And guess what? The mom probably know all the dirt that her son do, and she okay with it. Okay with it. Some of y'all evil, wicked, single women, y'all like that. Y'all uphold the sins of y'all kids, and y'all look how they turn out. And guess what? Know what they going to do? They going to have kids of their own, and they going to treat the mother just like you was treated. Right? It's time for our people to escape that plantation. All right? Got to escape that plantation. What's that? What's the next video? What's the next video I want? Let me see. Going more into, it says, we're going to deal with the same thing again. It says, the caregiver may expect frequent praise and affection from the child, or wish to feel that they are the most important thing in the child's life. All right, go to that video with, hold on 1 second. Let me get it. Go to the video with Jacob Copeland. Jacob Copeland, the one when they sitting down. All right. Some of y'all may have seen this video right here. Go ahead, play this real quick. This video right here.
My time soon for the next 3 to 4 years.
Hey, look at this wickedness right here. This brother right here just got, he got a scholarship to go play. He got his choice of schools. Right?
So I'm about to leave. So,
he get to go play. Look at this, look at this. She walk in front of him.
Going to Florida.
Right? Pause the video.
He just got up and left there.
Now, it's a lot of factors in this video that you gotta, that you're going to have to understand. You're going to hear it subtle, right? But guess what? He was picked to be, hey, can't y'all have me like in the, like the little screen? Because what happened, I'm going to forget what I'm talking about, all right? So what happens is, it's a lot of different factors in this video I want y'all to pay attention to. But just like we read about the definition of covert incest, she wishes to feel she's the most important thing in that child's life, right? At the expense of the child's other relationships. So we seen the other video. She didn't care about him being married and stuff like that. It don't matter, right? Also, dealing with some of the support and things like that. Like I read earlier, like she like the child's, her son's accomplishments to be her accomplishments. She wanted him to go to that school. She had the Alabama shirt on, and she had the Tennessee Scully on, right? But he didn't want to go to them schools. He wanted to go to Florida. Let's get the video back up.
She say, follow me.
Start it over again. Start it over one more time. I want y'all to listen. I want y'all to look at his face, and then I want y'all to listen to the commentator in the background. I want y'all to listen to them. Listen to what's going on. Play it again.
For the next 3 to 4 years.
Wait, go back. I want you to see something else. Because that's probably grandmother, friend that's all the way on the left-hand side. I want you to look at, okay, I want you to look at this lady all the way on the left and watch how she fake it. She going to act like she about to cry, and then she going to peek under her eye to see what the mom do, right? This right here is this, hey. She probably, I'm sure she the grandmother or she the best friend. She probably single too, right? Play it again.
Not like now, I'm taking my time for the next 3 to 4 years.
Watch the look, watch. Look, you saw look? It's so fake. Now listen to the commentator in the background. I want you to listen to him. Watch that.
Jacob, you're going to Florida. Who just got up and left there? And to your right, who got up and left?
Oh, that was my mom.
And why did she walk out and leave?
I don't know. I don't know exactly why she walked out, but yeah.
Now what? Now pause this thing.
Jacob, we saw.
Now what? What you think she just did to her son? Look at his face. Right? The first thing the commentator said was, who was that? Right? It's a mess going on. Right? I'm about to point out this mess. Who was that that got up? Who was that lady? Why did she get up? Right? This is one of the biggest moments in this young man's life. Right? He done grind. He done worked hard. He the number 5 wide receiver. I think he's like number 5 wide. No, number 40. He number 40. Out of all the wide receivers, he ranked number 40 in the world. And he number 5 somewhere else. I don't know what. But guess what? He done put in his work to get to that position to be picked by a Division I school, not just a Division I school, but he got Alabama, he got Tennessee, and he got the Florida Gators right there. On that day, this mom, she thought that her wants and needs was so important that she would embarrass this young man like that. This young man gonna remember this for the rest of his life, because guess what? It's gonna be on the internet. It's gonna be on the internet for his life. If he had kids, his kids gonna be able to watch this interview and be like, "What? Why grandma so damn wicked? Grandma the devil." Look at the dude on the right hand side. He looking like, man, they should have never gave these niggas money. That's what he thinking right now, right? Then you know behind you see the brother, he hugging on his pet. My bad, Becky, whatever her name is, who knows? But now the man had to get up and give the brother some support. I don't know if that's his dad or not. I can't remember. But hit play.
Wearing the Alabama sweater there.
Look at his eyes.
Conversations.
Watch
like
the young man eyes.
About where you were going to school.
We had a lot of conversations back and forth about where I should go to school at, but it was like God led me and my gut and God led me in the direction that my heart desired. So I followed along with it. I couldn't go with my mind. I wanted to go with my heart. So
he said, I can't go with my mama. I'm going where I want
to
go.
God led me on. He told me to pick my decision that I wanted, and that's what I choose.
I think you're going to start crying, though, somewhere
Jacob,
in here.
You referenced on Twitter yesterday, I saw the post.
Speed up a little bit. Speed up a little bit. Pass by a little bit. I think you're going to start crying.
I felt more welcome at home and felt like I could make an impact in at the University.
All right, pause it. Pause it. Get out of this. Did you still keep that other video of him? Go to that one. Go to the other video of him real quick. We still online. They ain't kick us offline for showing the videos. All praises to the higher most. That's what I'm talking about. The gates of hell will not prevail. Let's get these videos out. We got to see this stuff. We got to show the effects of this covert incest. You're nasty. Some of y'all says it's nasty. Y'all committing incest with your sons, and you don't know it. But guess what? We're going to let you know. What you're doing ain't right. Let's go to it. You found it? Put it up there. All right. Hit the play. Kind of go a little bit further. I think it's going to get to where she come back. Look at him. Look at him. He out there, he crying. She made this warrior cry in front of thousands of people. In front of thousands of people. She made her son cry on national TV because she a damn fool. Because she want to be the boss. Because she want her son to do what she want him to do. He up there crying. And look, here she come. Here she come. It's okay. You still my baby. Yo, what you going to hug him for? And look, she did that so she can get the praise. Hit the pause. She wanted to get the praise. Now she look like she the hero. Everybody start clapping. Let me go hug him right now. Oh, praise. Yeah, whatever. She the devil the Bible speaks of. That's a damn dragon right there. Man, look. I don't know who decided to mate with that thing. I'm going to be honest with you. I don't know. He didn't have sex with her. She had sex with him. But yeah, look at she made that warrior cry. She made that warrior cry, right? She's going to make him emotional. She's going to make him, guess what? How you think he feel about women right now? How you think he feel about black women that look like his mama? How you think he feel about black women with their natural hair? How you think he feel about them? He probably hate them. He probably hate their guts. That's why the other brother had a white boy back there. Because guess what? They don't want a woman that look like they mama. They don't want them stress troubles. Right? They don't heard some of these brothers be like, oh, nah, bro. Get you a Becky, bro. She'll iron your underwear. Iron your underwear? Wow. My mama wouldn't iron no iron to daddy, nothing. He go to work every single day. He don't get a meal when he come home. Or nothing. She don't iron his clothes or whatnot. You mean to tell me Becky iron your underwear? Hey, I need to find me a Becky then, right? Go, let's see. Give me another video. Let me see what video I want. Hold on one second. Let me find these videos. So we got the Jacob Copeland. Give me one of the LaDon Collins. Give me LaDon Collins. All right? LaDon Collins, real quick. Get to that video. Is that what I want? Yeah, play that thing. Hit play.
Landon Collins during his photo shoot, and now Landon Collins is standing by for our American and Family Insurance verbal commitment with Dari Noka.
Okay, so it's
the
same thing. It's
a
commitment.
With Landon Collins, the number one safety nationally in the ESPN U1.
Hold on. I don't think I want this one yet. Pause that. Hold on. I don't want this one. Hold on. Let me make sure which one I want. Because it's some let's see, it's 2014. I think it's that one. Let's go to that one first. Yeah, let's go to that one. That's the one I want.
To the national championship game, and are those your two? We know LSU and Alabama. Those are your two, right?
Yes, sir.
I can tell you this, through the world of social networking, your announcement is so highly anticipated, it's unbelievable. First off, how difficult was the decision?
Very difficult. Both teams are just top-notch to me, and I feel at home at both schools.
Now, you are literally from Geismar, Louisiana. Let's see if that plays into things here. LSU.
I'm from New Orleans.
You're from New Orleans.
Okay, all right. So let's hold on. Pause
still
real quick.
LSU country. I know that. LSU pause or Alabama, real fast. The number one safety in the country.
All right. So he from Louisiana. So he got two schools going on. You got LSU. You got Alabama. He was born and raised in Louisiana, right? That's where he from. All right. So, but he got his pick. To be the pick of those two schools right there, guess what? He got to be a good player, right? Let's hit play again.
Landon Collins will play his ball where?
It's a tough decision. I got both schools here, but I'm going to go Roll Tide Roll.
Hey, so he's going out. Look at his mama.
Alabama.
Look at her with a damn yellow hair in the head.
Safety in the country.
One of his most. Wait, guess what? It's a big day for him.
Biggest decision for me.
Look at her. She's smacking her lips. She's looking like she got an attitude. She mad. What's she mad for?
Now, might I ask you your reaction?
Stop. Pause it. It's the same thing that happened in the other video. Esau ain't dumb. Right? They know who run the household. They know who they want to run the household. They know who they want to put up in front. Right? So what he interviewing the mom for? She wasn't with him shooting in the gym. What are we talking about here? She ain't catch not one ball. I promise you she didn't. She ain't throw no ball. She ain't tackle nobody. She ain't got no touchdowns. Why is he talking to her? He's supposed to be talking to this young man. Right? Look at him. He got his head down. That's buck breaking 101. You sisters sometimes are the biggest buck breakers of yo men. It's you sisters, the black woman. You buck break your sons, right? I remember somebody was talking about buck breaking. It was a sister. She a single mother. She was like, how does a mother buck break her son? Just like this. He winning, and you don't want him to win. You want him to win how you want him to win. Because it's all about you. It's all about what make you happy. She don't want to drive to Alabama. She don't want to drive to Tuscaloosa. Nah, she wanna be able to drive 45 minutes down the road, right, to Tiger Stadium. She don't want to drive to Tuscaloosa. She don't want to get on the road and do that, right? That's, 5 hours? She don't want to drive 5 hours. She want to drive 45 minutes up the road. But guess what? Hey, and a lot of times, these boosters and things be making deals with these parents behind their kids' back. It's a ex-pro athlete that's in Israel United in Christ right now. He said that he found out that his mom and dad got money for him to go to the school that they wanted him to go to and not go to the school he really wanted to go to, right? So that's what be going on. It be money being given to these parents for them to stay in the state and things like that. Hey, look, especially in Louisiana, right? You get to go to this Chevrolet dealership. You can get your car, whatever, this and that. You ain't even got to pay for it. It just be riding around like a lease vehicle or whatnot, a demo, or what they call them, the demo vehicles, right? You don't have to do that. We'll let you do this. Just make sure your son come to LSU, right? That's what go on. But look at this picture. She got an attitude, right? She got her lips poked out. Look at the boys behind. He like, I thought we supposed to be happy. The little young boy in the white shirt, we supposed to be happy right now, right? He don't know what's going on. Grandma all the way to the right, she like, I raised the right. Hit play.
I there was not a lot of joy here. Can I ask why?
I feel this LSU is a better place for him to be.
It's closer. That's why you're selfish.
LSU Tigers, number one. Go yep. Tigers.
You're selfish.
You're making some friends.
LSU sucked this year, I might say.
Alabama, it is. What do you think the hometown?
So let's get off this video right here. All right, let's get off this video. Let's get another vehicle. Let's go to Gerald Williams III, that YouTube video. So you already had him. He's from New Orleans or whatnot. He could have went to two different schools. He picked the school. His mama ain't like it. She was mad. Let's go to this video. Let's go to this video right here. All right? Keep going. All right. Let's play this video right here.
We're all eagerly.
Now, if you look at his sister that's standing up, the video kind of choppy.
In the class.
Hit pause.
Out of New Orleans.
Now, if you look at this, they from New Orleans too, right? But if you look at this sister that's standing up right there in the multicolored dress, That's the same woman from the other video. So you mean to tell me she done gave birth to two All-American Division I athletes? They got different names, so you already know what that means. They got different last names, so you already know. She can't keep a man, right? Because she want to be the man. You know what I'm saying? They leave, they run. They got to get away from that dragon. But this is the mom. So that's his brother right there. Hit play.
Your brother, Landon Collins, a couple years ago went ahead and committed to Alabama. Now, your finalists are LSU and Florida. First off, what's the process been like for you whittling it down to these two?
It's been rough, you know. It's been a tough process, but I finally made my decision.
And April, Justin, I know you're the mom here.
Yes, I am.
I know a lot of folks remember you well from
talking to the woman again.
What's it been like for you going through this all again?
Oh, it's been a wonderful feeling again.
She looks, she's so happy.
Black
woman won't smile or nothing.
Here, LSU or Florida for Gerald Willis III. Where will you play your college ball?
I would take my talent to Gainesville, Florida.
Gainesville, Florida. Look at it. She's like, look, I'll slap you in your face right now.
Gerald
look at it. She's like, whatever. No emotion. She's just standing there. She ain't happy. She ain't clapping her hands or nothing.
Brother Landon, he's got the gloves on, ready to go. Your take on this decision, ma'am?
It is what it is.
It is what it is. Hit the pause button.
Hey, Kev. Hey, Kev, I got to say, imagine how that sister is behind closed doors.
Oh,
she don't get her way.
Right.
So think about them
kicking
brothers,
and screaming.
Them brothers had to dip. Can I get one script, Cap, real quick?
Yeah, get the scripture.
Proverbs 21:19. Real quick.
Hey, you made a point. Them brothers wanted to get away
them
from
that. Got their hell on. Imagine how she is at the house. She like that in public. Real quick.
The book of Proverbs, chapter 21 and verse 19. It is better to dwell in the wilderness than with a contentious and angry woman.
So the Bible says it's better to dwell in the wilderness than be with that contentious and angry woman. So them brothers had to deal with that sister behind closed doors. Knew, hey, it's time to go and get the hell on out of here. Better to dwell in the wilderness with an angry and contentious woman.
But that's their mama, though. She loved him. Hey, them two boys said, I got to go. I got to get away from my mom, right? Now I'm going to show you something about this. This has a lasting effect on men, right? A lasting effect on them. Let me show you something real quick. Let me find this other article right quick. Let me find this article. Go to the one NFL player's ex exposes him. Have him right there. It's a video. I think it's a video. I don't know. It's a rolling out. All right, so let's see. Read that for me.
NFL player exposes him for impregnating three women at the same time.
So I know a lot of you women may be like, man, this dude a nig right here, impregnating three women at the same time. I wonder who raised him. What's his name? Read.
Landon Collins.
Read under there.
Landon Collins, photo credit.
No, the article part.
New York Giants safety. Landon Collins recently became engaged to his girlfriend.
So guess what? That's Landon Collins, right? Guess who his mama is? That woman with the blonde hair that wasn't happy, that wanted him to stay in LSU in Louisiana and not move away. Guess what she gave birth to? Matter of fact, give me that scripture right quick. That scripture, what I want. Mistress women will bring forth monsters. Sirach, what, 20?
Second Ezra, five.
Brother, give me the wrong scriptures. What the hell is this? Give me, what a sound bite. What the hell is this? Okay, we don't have it. Don't worry, y'all. Why are we trying to get this going, right? You know, hey, IYC Birmingham, we on the come up right now, right? Subscribe to the YouTube channel. Hey, the videos is hitting. Right? That's all I gotta say. The video is hitting, right? You know, we ain't getting 15,000-20,000 views for nothing. We got some good videos going on. It's a lot going on in Birmingham. But look, we thinking about getting our own little radio show. You know what I'm saying? Where we gonna get our own show? We don't know the name though. We don't know the title. Hey, post. What y'all think? Maybe give us a title. We'll let the people decide. What kind of title for a good radio show? We looking for a title of a good radio show. So look, put it in the comment section or whatnot. You know, maybe we'll pick the best one. All right? All right. So what, you got that scripture for me?
Yes, sir.
Read it.
2 Ezra chapter 5 and verse 8.
Go ahead.
There shall be a confusion also in many places, and the fire shall be often sent out again, and the wild beasts shall change their places, and mistress women shall bring forth monsters.
Hey, that sister, she brought forth a monster. A monster. He was like, I got to get away from my mama because she evil. But it was too late. The brainwashing was already there, right? So what he did, go to the article. What did she create? She created a monster. Go back to the article for me real quick. Read it again.
New York Giants safety Landon Collins recently became engaged to his girlfriend, Victoria Lowry. While this should be a joyous time for the 22-year-old athlete.
Hey, look, it seemed like he had a lot of situations that supposed to have been joyous, but they weren't joyous.
Oh, turned wrong. Turned crazy.
Keep reading.
His ex-girlfriend has spoiled the good news by leaking personal information about Collins.
Man, it's always a woman spoiling his news. It started with his mama. Go ahead.
Including allegations that three different women.
How many women?
Three different women.
Read.
Neither of whom are his fiancée.
So you mean he engaged, but he got three different women, Reed.
Gave birth to his babies just months ago.
Wait a minute. So he don't have like a one-year-old, a three-year-old, and a five-year-old. He got three newborns, and he engaged, and she don't even know nothing about it. That scripture says, menstruous woman shall bring forth monsters. And y'all women be sitting around wondering, I don't know why men like that. I don't know why they like that. Because you raise them to be like that. That's why they like that. You raise them not to respect women. Because guess what? They hate you. And they don't want to be around you. Why? Because you wicked. You got everything out of order. You doing what the white man wanted. Matter of fact, go there. Give me that scripture. Give me the Willie Lynch real quick. Give me the Willie Lynch letter. Right? You're doing exactly what you were bred to do. Exactly what you were created to do. You're doing exactly what the slave master wants you to do. Exactly what he wants you to do. Give me that. Come up with the Willie Lynch letter real quick. Pull that up for me. Let's see. Go to the breaking process of the African woman. Let's read that.
The breaking process of the African woman.
Go ahead.
Take the female and run a series of tests on her to see if she will submit to your desires willingly. Test her.
Wait, stop. I got to laugh. Somebody put green eggs and Birmingham radio show. Hey, look, we ain't about to name no green eggs in Birmingham. What the hell? Hey, that's a good one, though. I like that. Green eggs and Birmingham. But go read. Who said that? Oh, that's funny right there. Read that. Go do it again.
The breaking process of the African woman. Take the female and run a series of tests on her to see if she will submit to your desires willingly.
So they're trying to say, let's see what we can do to see if she's going to submit to the desires of the slave master. Read.
Test her in every way.
Go ahead.
Because she is the most important factor for good economics.
She is important for good economics. It ain't talk about the economics of the black community or the black neighborhood. It ain't talk about the building of the 12 tribes of Israel, right? To making us no more two nations and bringing us to one nation again. Nah, not for those economics. She good for the economics of the slave master. She good for the slave master economics. Keep reading.
If she shows any sign of resistance in submitting completely to your will, do not hesitate to use the bull whip on her.
Go ahead.
To extract the last bit of resistance out of her.
Now, you got to understand that you sisters, right? They beat y'all too. A lot of y'all, you know, y'all want to marry Biff and Jake and William and all these different Bartholomew. A lot of y'all married to Bartholomew. But guess what? Bartholomew's grandfather used to beat your grandmother, used to rape your grandmother, used to send her off to private islands. What's that dude that they say killed himself? That millionaire, a billionaire that they say killed himself. He hung himself in jail. But, yeah, Epstein, right? Right? He had islands. He had an island where they had all kinds of, like, sex parties and things like that. Guess what? They had that back in the day where they'd take your grandmother, your great-grandmother, all these female slaves out there, and they'd do all kinds of stuff to them, right? Guess how they came up with gynecology, right? How they learned that on the slave woman, right? They put the slave woman in the room. And just start cutting on her. Hey, what does this mean? Oops, dang, oops, what oops mean? Oops, I messed up. All right, let's go get another one. That's what they did. They figured out how to do it. Think about this. They figured out how to remove the womb of a woman by practicing on a black slave without anesthesia. They were just in there just snip, 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 snip. Ah, you know, she's screaming. They probably got duct tape on her. They got the other slave women in the other room hearing her scream and struggle and stuff like that, right? And they did that all for the praise of the white woman, right? The white woman, she evil too. But we get to that another day, right? Read back what you had.
Take care not to kill her.
Don't kill her.
For in doing so, you spoil good economics.
Go ahead.
When in complete submission, she will train her offspring in the early years to submit to labor when they become of age.
Read.
Understanding is the best thing. Therefore, we shall go deeper into this area of the subject matter concerning what we have produced here in this breaking process of the female nigger. We have reserved the relationship in her natural uncivilized state. She will have a strong dependency on the uncivilized nigger male, and she will have a limited protective tendency toward her independent male offspring.
Go ahead.
And would raise male offspring to be dependent like her.
To do what?
To be dependent like her.
That's what's going on, right? That's that emotional, effeminate, right? She gonna raise her son to be emotional, effeminate, to act like a woman, right? Read.
Nature had provided for this type of balance. We reverse nature by burning alone, unprotected, with the male image destroyed. The ordeal caused her to move from her physical dependent state to a frozen independent state.
So the woman, like we said, like we read earlier about how, like, she's supposed to depend on who? On her husband for all these, for being stable, for her desires, right? For her emotional support. She's supposed to get that from her husband, right? But guess what? She was bred to do the opposite. She was bred to do the exact opposite. Keep reading.
In this frozen psychological state of independence, she will raise her male and female offspring in reversed roles.
It says she frozen. Guess what? Her mind is in the plantation. And that's what we're trying to get you single sisters and you women in general with kids, with sons to do. We're trying to get you to escape the plantation. Because guess what? You may have a job, but guess what? In your mind, guess what? You still on that cotton field. You still picking cotton, right? You still breastfeeding master son. That's what's still going on in your mind. You got to escape that plantation. Right now, your mind is frozen. Keep reading.
For the fear of the young male's life,
go ahead.
She will psychologically train him to be mentally weak.
To be what?
Mentally weak.
You ain't see the state of those two men? Mentally weak. She made her son cry. That sister made her son cry on national TV. It's on ESPN. It's gonna be on the internet forever. It ain't never going nowhere. This strong warrior, right? She made him cry. These other two brothers, the best days of their life, guess what they end up doing? Looking down at the ground, knowing that their mom don't approve. Right? Keep reading.
She will psychologically train him to be mentally weak and dependent.
Go ahead.
But physically strong.
You seen them doing what they about to do? They about to get entered into Division I college football and then go to the next level to be what? NFL players. So guess what? Physically, they were some warriors. Right? They were the best of the best. He's top 40 in the wide receivers of the whole nation. Right? So he was trained to be physically strong, but mentally, where it really counts, he was weak. Go ahead.
Because she has become psychologically independent, she will train her female offspring to be psychologically independent.
Guess what? All my single ladies, all my I can't sing, y'all. But guess what? That's what's in her head. She listening to Beyonce. Some of y'all women stupid, too. I'm just going to say stupid. Y'all singing Single Ladies, a song performed by Beyonce, who's married to Jay-Z. That's the dumbest thing I ever heard in my life. Right. It's dumb, right? The only reason I know how to spell independent is because of a shout-out to Lil Webby. I-N-D-E. What are you talking about? You want an independent woman. That boy, that's a grown kid. That's a grown child, right? And he's singing about being independent. Y'all women are like, yeah, I'm independent. Like, that's a good thing. That's you proud. If you let somebody bust up in you, shoot the club up, and he left you, that's something to be proud about, right? Wrong. All right, Ricky Reading.
What have you got? You've got the nigger woman out front.
You got her out front. That's why, and though, guess what? In those videos, what happened? What happened in those videos, right? They was like, whoa, who was that that walked in front of the thing? It's the mom. What's going on? Hey, what do you feel about this nigger lady? Oh, I don't like it. Oh, this happened a couple years ago. Let's find out what the woman wants. The police come to your house. Guess what? They want to look. They want to. They say they teach the police to find the oldest woman in the house to go to. Let me tell you something, brothers. When you go into the restaurant, right? You go into the restaurant and you walk in there, and they like, it's you and your girl, you and your wife. And the first thing they do is look at your wife to ask who there. She better not say a word. You tell your wife, don't say a word. There's a man in the building. They need to deal with the man.
Right.
I'll be like, hey. Yeah, I'm right here. The checkbook right here. The credit card right here. Right? But now they want to talk to the woman. They want to be looking over you. I'm like, hey, snap your fingers at them. Be like, hey, yeah, right here. The questions come right here. Because the world understands that the black woman rules over the black man. The world understands that. And that's what keeps us on the bottom. It keeps us in submission. It keeps our mind in the plantation. Y'all got to escape that thing. Where we at? Keep reading.
You got the nigger woman out front.
You got her out front, read.
And the nigger man behind and scared.
And you got the man behind and scared. Grown warrior on national TV crying like a baby girl. Reek,
this is a perfect situation.
It's perfect for the slave master. It's perfect. You ever see some of them Black Lives Matter rallies and you got a sister up there, she got some spandex on and a shirt with her chest all out, and she up there trying to be, you can't tell us what to do, Black Lives Matter.
And y'all in the police face like that.
Yeah, she in the police face, like, dressed like a whore, acting like she gonna do something. The other nations ain't scared of you, black woman. The only thing is they just don't want to hear your mouth. They wish you just shut up. That's all. They ain't afraid of you. They just do what you tell them to do because they don't want to hear your mouth. Right? They don't want to hear that. They what to say the scripture about how they'll use our women to run away the army, right? That's about it. But anything else, y'all are good for good economics. Good economics. Keep the man in the back. Keep him scared. Keep him afraid. Keep him with his head down. Keep him feeling like he's a slave. Keep reading.
This is a perfect situation of sound sleep and economic.
They can sleep well at night knowing that the black woman is in charge. They know if the black woman in charge, guess what? They sleep real good at night. They ain't afraid. They ain't thinking about no uprising or whatnot, right? Because they know they're teaching that young man to what? To be weak, right? To be mentally weak and physically strong. It's like as long as he's strong and he's making our money, then that's good. Push some more, pump some more weights. You know what I'm saying? Get stronger. But you better not use your brain. Nope, not doing that. Keep reading.
Before the breaking process, we had to be alertly on guard at all times.
Guess what? Before they did this, you had slaves trying to escape the plantation.
Right.
They were trying to escape the plantation. But guess what? You put the woman in front. She raised her daughters to be independent, just like her, and they raised their sons to be weak and docile. And that's the black community for you right there. That's the black community. Go to Jeremiah chapter 11 and verse 19 right here. The one thing the other nations, they know and understand, and it's written in the Bible, is that they have to take the power away from the man to destroy the nation, to destroy the family, to destroy the structure that God put together. They know the one person they got to get out the way, it's the husband. Read that.
Jeremiah chapter 11 and verse 19.
Go ahead.
But I was like a lamb or an ox that is brought to the slaughter.
A lot of our sisters like this. A lot of you single mothers, you like this. You are like, you just out there. You just doing what you think is right. You just doing what feel okay or right to you, right? Because your mama raised you this way or because you watch all these different stupid shows that's on. Y'all got to stop watching these stupid shows that's on. Like what it says, evil communication corrupt good manners. Y'all, if you watching Basketball Wives, Atlanta Housewives, Married to Medicine, what's the other shows they got? Love and Hip Hop. If you watching these shows, they ain't doing that but going to make you wicked, wicked, wicked. If you watch, I'm telling you. You got NeNe, she wicked as hell, right? You got all these different, look, it is what it is. These shows ain't right. right? You watching these shows and you feeling your head and you wondering why you act this way. Because you watching these shows that tell you it's okay. Read that.
But I was like a lamb or an ox that is brought to the slaughter.
Read.
And I knew not that they had devices against me.
They got devices against you, single mother. They got all kinds of devices against you. These TV shows are against you. They're not for you. They're not for bringing forth a nation. They're not for you to bring forth strong men to marry a woman, to raise their kids, to assist in building that nation. They're not doing that. That's not what this stuff was set up for. All these different shows and these devices that were set up by a slave master was set up to do exactly what it's doing. Keep us on the plantation. Read.
Saying, let us destroy the tree.
Destroy what?
Let us destroy the tree.
Let us destroy the man, the father. Read.
With the fruit thereof.
With the what?
With the fruit thereof.
We're going to use the woman to destroy the tree with the kids. So let's poison the dirt. What they say? We're going to poison this dirt, right? It's going to bring forth a weak tree. And guess what? The fruit from that tree going to be rotten. And it's going to further do what? Fall into the dirt, keep the dirt and soil messed up, and keep that process over and over and over again. That's what they want to do. And guess what? Y'all making it easy because you independent. You independent. I don't need no man. Okay, let's see if you don't need no man when the grocery stores ain't got food in them no more. Right. Let's see if you're going to need a man then. Let's see. We'll see if you don't need a man when the supply chain lock up and it ain't no grocery store, right? When Amazon stopped delivering. We ain't no more. What's they call that? When you're delivering 2 days?
Prime.
When they ain't got no more Amazon Prime. Right? When you ain't got nobody to get nothing off the shelf for you. When you ain't got nobody to pick up nothing heavy for you. We'll see. We'll see if you need a man in that day. The scriptures talk about that. You're going to come back talking about something. I just want to be called by your name. I'm going to eat my own bread. Just let me be called by your name. It's going to be too late then. The correction and understanding coming out right now. You sisters, guess what? You ain't strong. You ain't a strong black woman. You ain't a strong Hispanic woman. Guess what? You weak. You weak. You need a hedge. You need somebody to point you in the right direction. Telling you. Y'all sitting back saying y'all independent. Okay. We'll see. We'll see. Let's say it on that scripture.
No, sir.
Keep reading.
And let us cut him off from the land of the living, that his name may be no more remembered.
Somebody said there's no sound. We got sound still? All right, we got sound. Maybe it's yours. All right, go ahead. Well, so what happens?
And let us cut him off from the land of the living.
Let's cut him off for the land of the living, right? We can't build no nation that way, right? That's what they know, right? All right, let's get another one, right? So we got that brother, right? So now show me the one about Gerald Willis, all right? Is that Gerald Willis? Yeah, this is the other brother right here, Gerald Willis. So now we just dealt with Landon Collins. That's one of her sons. Let's go to the other son. All right, let's see what kind of career this young man had when he left dealing with his mom. Let's see what kind of person he became. Read that.
Freshman defensive lineman Gerald Willis III, dismissed from Gators football team.
Wait a minute, so he got kicked off the team. He got kicked off the team, right? Read that.
The Florida Gators have dismissed freshman defensive lineman Gerald Willis III, according to the football program's Twitter account.
Read.
The Gators seem to pull a recruiting coup at last year's Under Armour All-American game when they beat out LSU for Willis, a native of New Orleans.
So guess what? Florida said, we got a good slave. We got a good slave right here. We got him out. We got a good slave for our plantation. Read that.
Willis was a five-star recruit according to 247 Sports Ranking and expected to have an...
Just go to instead.
Instead, Willis mostly was a headache.
But guess what? He was a headache. You know why he was a headache? Because he was emotionally unstable. He was emotional. He was a mama's boy. Mama's boy don't like order, right? You can't tell me nothing. You ain't my mama. You ain't my mama. What's wrong with you? You say something like that, you ain't my mama, you ain't right. Keep reading, read that.
He was suspended twice for undisclosed reasons.
He was suspended twice. This is his first year there, Reed.
And was involved in a fight over cleats with the third-string quarterback, Skyler Morningwig.
Wait, he got into a fight because of what? Read that again.
He was suspended twice for undisclosed reasons and was involved in a fight over cleats.
He was fighting over shoes. What that sound like to y'all? To me, that sound like a mama's boy. To me, that sound like somebody that's emotional. Straight Carl Thomas around this joint. I'm emotional. Hey, that brother emotional. You want to know why? Because you sisters raise your sons to be like that. Bring forth monsters. As for our people, children are their oppressors, and women rule over them. The Bible tells the truth all day long. There ain't no lies in this Bible. It tells us the reason why this stuff happened. This brother got into a fight over stitches with a third-string quarterback. Over cleats with a third-string quarterback. What you fighting with a third-string quarterback for? You got drafted. You a starter, right? Keep reading.
Morningwig needed stitches after Willis punched him.
He beat the dude so bad he needed stitches, right? Let's see. Keep reading.
Willis' best game and most memorable play was in what turned out to be his final game at UF. The Gators' 28-20 win last Saturday in the Birmingham Bowl.
All right. So he had one good game, right? He finished with four tackles. Go up. Let's see if anything else on that. I can't remember. Shout out to Austin Stickerbush, DJ Abishak on the ones and twos. Look, the best IT in all Israel. Boy, ain't no way, boy. You ain't hit that on the boy, ain't no way, boy, on this one, huh? Now go to the next one. Go.
Boy, ain't no way, boy.
Boy, ain't no way, boy. All right, go
boy,
to the next
no
one.
Ain't no way, boy.
Go to the next one dealing with him. The Wikipedia one. Go to the Wikipedia one. This one right here, this is going to show his professional stats, right? This was in Wikipedia about this brother here. Y'all got it? All right, so read his name at the top.
Gerald Willis III.
All right. Let's see. I don't want that. Go down. No. Matter of fact, go to the right a little bit. This is history, right? This is brother history right here. Keep going down. Go to read that career history.
Career history.
Nah, that's not what I want. It say something else. Go up real quick. Something I'm missing. To the left or to the right, whichever way. Let me see. Hold on real quick. Go down. All right, yeah, read that under Baltimore Ravens.
Professional career, Baltimore Ravens. Despite being projected to be a mid-round pick, Willis went unselected in the 2019 NFL draft.
So he didn't even get drafted, right? This guy, he didn't even get drafted. Now, he was supposed to go, even this one show, he's supposed to go mid-round pick, right? But he didn't even get drafted, right? And one thing y'all got to understand that y'all don't understand, y'all think, a lot of people be saying, like, all these football players, you can just do whatever you want. They're dry. No, they won't. No, sir, no, ma'am. Right? If they feel like you're going to be a problem and you're going to mess up their money, they are not picking you. So he went undrafted, right? Now go to the right. We're showing the other ones. Now go down a little bit. The other way. My bad. Up. Go up a little bit. Up. Now go to the right or left. I don't know what I'm looking at. All right, so go to his career history. Read that career history.
Career history. Baltimore Ravens, 2019.
All right, read.
Miami Dolphins, 2019.
So he didn't stay on the team. He had to go to another team, read.
Green Bay Packers, 2020.
So guess what? He went in two years, or really maybe even 1 year, depending on how you look at it. In 2 years, guess what? He played for three different teams, right? And then on the first team and the last team, he was either there for the off season. Or he was a practice squad member only. Guess what? That emotional attitude, nah, they ain't going to let you play on that team. Go down. All right. Let's see. Now, look at his career statistics as of 2019. What he got?
Career NFL statistics as of 2019.
Read.
Total tackles, two.
Two tackles. That boy was balling, boy. He was mentally unstable. He was mentally unstable. And guess what that was caused by? This is what you think. It says, well, we read about incest, about covert incest. It says that it has some of the same results as actual incest. So you got to think about it. Just think if she was having sex with him, mom's having sex with the son, he'd be messed up. He couldn't deal with stuff. Same way, he messed up. He can't deal with stuff, right? So both her sons in their latter life was messed up. You know, they was, guess what? They was physically strong. They was able to be All-American football players, get drafted to certain teams and stuff like that. He was able to do that kind of thing, right? But when it came to what really matters, the mental side, they couldn't do it because they was emotional. You know why? Because their mama raised them to be that way. And that's it what it is. Now, let's see. Let's see. I think I'm past my time, but we're going to roll on. I don't think nobody going on. We're going to keep it rolling. We're going to keep it rolling. I'll be looking at some of these classes he be doing. It'll be long, so we got time. Let's see. I'm going to skip that one. I'm going to go to this one article right now. Let's go to Emmitt Smith. Let's go to the Emmitt Smith one right here. Let's see something. Let's see how it's supposed to go. Emmitt Smith. Go to the Emmitt Smith one real quick. All praises. I hit play.
In Dallas, EJ Smith joins us now. EJ, appreciate you sharing this.
Oh, look at this sign today.
Time to share your decision.
Pause real
quick. Where are you headed to school?
Pause real quick. Now,
first and foremost,
even though the mama's got that yellow hair, she don't know no better, right? And, you know, whatever. It is what it is. But look at that. We got a father on the left-hand side. And look what he got on. He got a suit and tie on. You know, he looking like something. Some of y'all brothers in the truth, y'all, hey, man. Some of y'all, you know, y'all dress crazy, man. You know what I'm saying? Y'all brother want to wear flip-flops every day, jeggings. They know what they call them, no, joggers. What they call them damn things? I don't know what they call. You know what I'm saying? Go out the house looking any kind of way. Not to say that this should be the standard right here, but guess what? When Paul talked about us having to deal, that we were having to speak to who? Who's going to speak to? We're going to speak to the, we're going to deal with the kings. We're going to talk to kings and stuff like that. Right? Guess what? What's wrong? No sound or something? Okay. Let's get a battery in there. What y'all doing? Are we going too long? We messed up? Damn. All right. Whatever. Hit the play button.
Thank my family and God for putting me in this position. I want to thank Jesuit, my coaches, my teachers, and everybody for helping me through my journey. Also want to thank Shelton for all the things that they have done for me in order to be in this position. And the next 4 years, I'm going to Stanford University.
Look at that excitement. Look at that. Is he happy? Look at the dad happy. Look, she like, look, well, I'm so proud of you, my son. That's what I'm talking about, my boy. That's what I'm talking about. That's the way it's supposed to be. He's supposed to be happy right now. He's supposed to smile. Look at the mom. She about to put on the fake tears. Right? But he's supposed to be happy. He's supposed to be happy right now. All right, take it down. That's the way it was supposed to be. If that other sister had a hedge over her, that's how it wouldn't be. You think Emmitt Smith was going to go with that sister? Like, nah. Because that's he may not be keeping the commandments, but he's still manly. How about that? He manly. We know a man is somebody keeping the commandments, 1 Kings 2 and 2. But guess what? He was that hedge to make sure that what? There wasn't no BS going on, right? And I was going to look up to see how he came out, but I didn't. So it is what it is. All right, so they say I don't have that much time right now. All right. So now when we go back to that news article where it was talking about the different examples of covert incest, right? So Let's go back to that one. The Medical News Today article. Examples of covert incest real fast. All right. Let's go to that third example right here.
Invade the child's privacy.
Read.
This may involve invading the child's personal space frequently or preventing the child from having a space of their own.
Mm-hmm.
The caregiver may also do things that make the child feel uncomfortable, such as ignoring the child's wish for privacy when they are nude or being nude around the child.
Invading a child's privacy. All right, let's keep read that next one. These kind of go together.
Treat the child like a romantic partner.
Treat the child like a romantic partner. Some of you women treat your sons like that's your husband. It is what it is. It is. He don't want to take all them selfies with you. He don't want to take selfies with you. Ah, he's my baby. Look, he's taking his selfies. Look at us together. Look, we wearing matching clothes. Look, he don't want to do that. Mama, why you always got to make me dress up like you? He don't want to do that. Boys don't want to do that. They don't want to do that. Stop taking a million selfies with you and your son. That ain't your man. He ain't your boyfriend. That ain't your husband. That's your son. You should be raising him to be a man. If you sisters were single and you got to get with a brother and you go to his Facebook and he got 1,000 selfies of himself, what you going to think about that brother? You going to think he got a little fruit, a little juice in his tank. And then what they call it? A little sugar in his tank. He got all these selfies of himself. He up there looking like Derek Zoolander or something. What? This is for Tigra. All these different looks and stuff. You're going to be like, something ain't right. Something ain't right. Why he got all these pictures of himself? But guess what y'all do? Y'all raise your sons taking 1,000 selfies with them. Stop taking all these selfies with your kid. Look, we know you love your kid. We know. We know you love them. That's your baby or whatnot. Stop raising them to be a punk. Stop raising him to be effeminate. Stop it. Wait, let me say it one more time. Stop it. They don't want to be in the camera with you. They don't want you kissing on them all the time. They don't want that, right? Send him on his way. Let him go outside and get tackled. Let him break a bone or something, right? Let him go outside and play some tackle football. Let him break a bone, right? He'll be all right. Let's see what it says. Read that, the romantic partner.
Treat the child like a romantic partner.
That's covert incest. Covert incest. That's my baby. We wearing matching outfits. We going to get a photo shoot. Hey, I'm going to tell you something. A lot of these people who do professional, these photo shoots, they making so much money now. They making big money now. My brother-in-law, his wife do that. She make big money doing photo shoots, and she's taking pictures with all these sisters and their sons, and they put them on the internet. Why? So they can feel good. Y'all out of order. Keep reading.
This could involve the caregiver taking the child on dates.
On what?
On dates.
I'm out on a date with mama's baby. I'm out on a date with the mama with the man that's in the household. That's what y'all do. Y'all, I see it on Facebook all the time. I be wanting to say something to it, but I ain't gonna say nothing. You know, it is what it is. I'm saying it now.
I don't know if you remember this, Cal, but y'all remember Bebe's kids.
Uh-huh.
And when Robin Harris' character met the sister, she said that if you want to date me, you got to date my children too.
Mm.
That's how they end up going out to the amusement park with all the kids too.
Ah,
so she took them all. All on went with them.
Yeah, she had to have her man. The most important thing had to be with her, right? Keep reading.
Discussing their sexual experiences.
Mm.
Or inappropriately commenting on the child's body or appearance.
A lot of y'all sisters do that. A lot of times y'all do that. Well, no, they do that with the men. They be like, oh, he going to be a savage out there in these streets. Mm-hmm. Right? He going to be running through them. I done seen posts like this. Some of y'all do the same thing with the women. Like, oh, look at her. Look at her with your little daughters. Y'all be like, yeah, look, she got a butt on her. She got a tail on her. Right? This is what y'all single women do to y'all kids. Guess what? That's incest. That's sexual abuse. You abusing your kids. You don't know it, but you are. They're going to grow up confused. They're going to grow up emotional. They're growing up out of order. The course of the world is out of order because you want to feel good. You want to feel good. If you want to feel good, guess what you're going to do? You're going to keep the laws of God. You're going to do the work. You're going to present yourself in a manner that make a righteous man want to marry you. And then you're going to feel good. You ain't going to feel good by dressing your son up like you. Keep reading.
The caregiver may also insist that the child call them names typically reserved for adult partners.
We call them names reserved for adult partners. Y'all got nicknames for each other. That's a little Pookie Boo. That's my little this. Call him his name. He got a name. You gave him the name. Call him his name. Stop giving him all these little pet names and making them emotional. And then when his friends find out, guess what they do? Guess what they're going to do? They're going to call him this name. Oh, little Sticker Bush. Hey, we gave Sticker Bush that name, though. You know what I'm saying? It is what it is. But I'm just saying, they going to give their kids these little nicknames and little, that's my little Juju. That's my little this. That's my little that. Call him his name. He got a name. Y'all putting them emotional spirits on your son, and then when he twitching, with somebody blowing his back out, and then he transmitting AIDS all throughout the nation because he confused. He don't know if he should be with a man or be with a woman. It's your fault. Y'all want to be like, men ain't nothing. Men ain't this. Men ain't that. You made them like that. You created a monster. And I'm going to tell you about today. It is what it is. I hope you ain't mad at me. Sisters that do this, look, it is what it is. The Bible's supposed to make you mad. It's supposed to point out your wrongs and the things that you're doing that ain't right. That's what the Bible's supposed to do. Correction, rebuke, reproof. That's what the Bible about. This ain't Creflo Dollar Church where it make you feel good and give me your money. No, the Bible's supposed to tell you what ain't right. What ain't right about you and how to fix that about yourself. Right? Let's sit on that. Watch. We're going to get you some pictures. We got some pictures right here. All right? Give me some of those pictures. Y'all know what I want. I posted some pictures. I guess sent some pictures in the group. I know I did. Y'all sounds confused over there. All right. Show you some of these pictures. Some of these pictures that some of y'all sisters be having with your sons. Going on a photo shoot with your sons. The hell is this? Oh, look at that. Look at that. What are you kissing her stomach for? Why is she naked? Why is she almost naked? Why she ain't got no clothes on? And look, he got this shirt that say king. You ain't no king. Man, I wish I would have my wife be like, let's take some pictures like this. No, I ain't taking no pictures like that. I got to, why? She got to feel good about, make her, she got the crown on her head, right? He a simp, and the son going to be emotional mother's boy. Look at, where's leg? Oh, yeah, he got his little legs crossed like he ain't got nothing there. She probably make him tuck it in, right? Look at it. Look at it. Look at the picture. She out there half naked. The little son kissing her. What he kissing her stomach for? The bottom right, they hugging up each other. It's one picture with the man in it. One picture, but her husband in two pictures. No, in three pictures. Her real husband in three pictures. Give me another picture. I got another picture on there. Give me the other pictures. Yeah, I'm on y'all women's tail today. I'm on your bumper because y'all ain't right. And y'all doing this to these men. And they growing up confused. They growing up feeling like stuff ain't right. Right? This going on. Y'all creating these monsters. Look at that. Why he ain't got no shirt on? He is not still breastfeeding. I promise you he ain't. Why is she there? Why is she looking in his eyes like that? It's supposed to be her husband in that picture with her. Where the man at? I bet he ain't no man around. Cause who gonna, does he have, does the boy have clothes on? Is he naked? Why he ain't got no shirt on? You think he this right? Nah, this ain't right. This ain't right. Stop doing this with your sons. This wicked right here, this out of order. You creating monsters. That's incest right there. That's covert incest. That's mental. He's sitting around remembering the time where he was in the room with his mama. She ain't had no shirt on. And they was, it looked like they probably naked. Or she got a drawers on. He ain't got no shirt on. He his naked chest rubbing up against his mom right next to her bosom. Who the cameraman? What? The cameraman looking at his mama without a shirt on. Some of y'all brothers, y'all in that field where y'all taking these taking cameramen for these sisters, right? I'm telling you, I don't know what go on. These sisters come in there, they want to get naked, they want to bend over, they want to toot it up, and they got their sons with them. Get on the next picture. What else we got? I got some more pictures. I sent you some other stuff. One more. Post a picture. Look at that. Look at that. That's my little husband right there. Why your chest all open? The little boy looking. He ain't breastfeeding no more, sister. Why you dressed like a hoe in front of your son? Why? Why? I ain't never gonna forget. I remember this one sister. This brother I know, and his mom used to always come to the school. She was dressed like a hoe. Every single time she came to the school. And he was so embarrassed because all we did, everybody talked about getting with his mama. And she loved it. She loved coming around in the shortest of tennis skirts with her chest out, looking like a hoe. She loved looking like a hoe, right? She probably was messing with some of, she wasn't messing with me. But she probably was messing with some of his friends. I don't know. Maybe. But look at this picture right here. Somebody be like, ain't nothing wrong with that picture. Ain't nothing wrong with what she got on. It's a lot wrong. Why is hand on her chin like that? Like he about to kiss her on the lips. That's an intimate picture right here. Where her hand at? Where the hell her hand at? Is it under his shirt? Is it close to his groin area? She grabbing his little hips? Hey, look. Get away. Don't do the close-up. Got all the damn melons in the string. The hell is this? All right, get out the scripture. Buzz about to get out the spirit. All right. Let's see. I sent a video. Yeah. Give me the Kodak Black vid. No. Give me the one with the mom live. Say that.
But check this out one more time. Let me know what your thoughts are. Watch it again.
All right, look at it. Look. Got the baby. She got a fake butt. That ain't real. And look at that. She got a son in the video. Now, you think she gonna get a husband like this? Oh, look at her hair. She got the green. What color is it? That's green. It look like it's teal.
Cute baby.
All right, go ahead and take it off. Take it off right here. Now, what? Just leave it right there. Some of y'all black sisters think that that's okay. Some of y'all women think that's fine. Oh, look at that. Look how cute. She making him a man. Know what she creating? She creating a little monster. She creating somebody that's going to have a fiance and get three different women pregnant at the same time. That's what she creating. And I don't think nothing wrong with it. These women create the men they say they hate. Create them. They're like, oh, y'all men ain't nothing. Y'all raised us that way. I know some of y'all probably saying, well, the men leave. We ain't talking about the men. We talking about y'all. Talking about your yambass. That's what we talking about. I didn't say that. It was also a liar. Can't believe you spoke like that, sir. But that's what we talking about. We talking about y'all. And this is what y'all do. It's videos all over on YouTube like this. I typed it in. Bam. All videos came up like this. Bunches and bunches of videos like this. The women think they had another video when they had the little baby touch the woman on the butt and stuff like that. But guess what? When you do all that, give me the Kodak Black video. I think I put the timestamp on there. So this Kodak Black is a rapper. And he up there dancing with his mama. You know what I'm saying? Hey, hold on. Wait a minute. What just happened there? Go back a little bit. Go back to, well, what the heck? Now, he was dancing with his mom. I think it was her birthday or something was going on. I can't remember. You know, he was in jail for a while. You know, he real emotional. You know, he one of them, what they call him in Florida, he a little young jit. That's the word. That's how you say it. He a jit. I'm still cool. I'm 40, son, but I'm still cool. He a jit. Little young jit out there in Florida. I don't know. He say he an Israelite, too. Guess what? That's why I let you know. Just because somebody make a song say they're an Israelite, I think on the song it says, I'm an Israelite. My diamonds are real ice or something like that. It's like, what? He just wanted something to rhyme. Yeah, so he say I'm sorry, y'all. He say he's an Israelite. So guess what? Y'all going to go crazy like, ah, Kodak Black Israelite. Nah, he got to keep the commandments. Let these celebrities keep the commandments. So he with his mama. I'm sure she ain't married. I could be wrong. But if I had to bet, I would say she a single mother, and she raised a little jit. She raised a little jit to, what do you call him, the Project Baby? Black Jesus. What's his name? He's got all these little dicks. Project Baby. That's his name, the Project Baby. All right, Kodak Black. That's how Christ look, y'all. He about that color. All praises. Now, here, play again. Let's see what's going on. He dance with his mama. Oh, how cute. Whoa! Oh, wait a minute. Oh, look. Hold on. And then he put his hand in his pants after that. He didn't just touch the cheek, though. He went in the middle. He was like cheek to, oh, middle. That's what he did. Why y'all think he did that? You think this is his first time having that intimate experience with his mom? You know what? You know why he did that? Because she be taking selfies with him all the time when he was a baby. She probably get out the shower naked in front of him like some of y'all women do. Don't do that, right? Don't be naked in front of your sons. It don't matter if he your baby. It don't matter how old he is. Don't be naked in front of your sons. Don't do that. The videos. Okay, what was that? Yeah, so we got Kodak Black out here doing what? He up there rubbing his mom. He rubbing his mom butt. That's what he's doing. And like I said, what made him do that? Because she treated him like she was what? She treated him like she, that was her boyfriend. That was her husband. That was her boo. That was her baby. That was her little JoJo. That's her little jit. That's her man. That's how she treated him. A lot of y'all sisters be just like that. Look at my little baby. He just growing up. He just growing up. Look at him. Look how big he getting. Look at him. Look, nobody care. We don't need to see that on Facebook all day. He don't want to take them pictures. He don't want to take all them selfies with you. Don't post a picture with y'all kissing. He don't want to do that. You making him do that. You are creating a monster. That's what you're doing. You creating a monster. I know some of y'all don't know. Some of y'all like, I didn't know that. Well, now you know. So guess what? Stop doing it. Delete the pictures and stop doing it. It's okay to take a picture every now and then, but dang. Every day? Selfie, selfie, selfie? This my baby? This my baby? Take a picture of him. Don't stop taking pictures of him. Leave him alone. Take a picture of you on a date with a man. Take a picture of you proving a brother. Take a picture of you in the school doing works for the Most High God. You know what I'm saying? Take a picture of you doing that. Let's see a picture of you what's the scripture talk about? Something washing the feet of the saints. You know what I'm saying? Take a picture of you in the kitchen cooking something. How about that? Let's recognize those four S's. Now don't take a picture of all the S's though. You know what I'm saying? Don't take a picture of all the S's. But let's take a picture of you making a sandwich, right? Take a picture of you in a class learning how to be submissive. You know, we don't want to see a picture of you and your kid. We don't want to see that no more. Stop it. Right? Let's go back to, let's see. I think that's all I had. I think I had another article or something. Let me see. Let me make sure. Let me make sure. I think I had something else. I had a couple more, but I think we good. I think we good. I think we good. I want you to go back to that Kodak Black video one more time because I want people to see this thing. I want people to see this thing. I want y'all to understand that this is what's going on in the community. And y'all may see this video and think, oh, well, that's just Kodak Black. No. It ain't just Kodak Black. Some of y'all women let your son sleep in the bed with you 3, 4, 5, 6, 10, 15 years old. Y'all letting your little kid sleep in the bed with you. You got your drawers on and a bra, t-shirt and panties on. You got your son laying right next to you in the bed. He messed up. He confused because that ain't right. It don't supposed to happen. He don't supposed to see your nakedness. That ain't supposed to happen. Go to that Kodak Black again. Wicked. Look, everybody laughing. It's a joke for everybody. Everybody having a good time. All right. Take it off this. Go to Baruch 4. Baruch 4 and verse 28. Baruch 4 and verse 28. Read that real quick.
Baruch chapter 4 and verse 28.
Go ahead.
For as it was your mind to go astray from God.
So we look, sisters, we understand that, right? Some of y'all didn't know this stuff wasn't right. Y'all was raised to be this way. Your mothers raised you to be this way. You saw it, the example of the world. It was already in your mind to go astray, right? So guess what? Now you know better, so you should do what? Keep reading.
So, being returned, seek him 10 times more.
So guess what? You got to seek him 10 times more. If you know you've been making these mistakes with your son, if you know you've been committing covert incest with your sons, or your sons with an S, guess what you got to do? You got to go 10 times harder to reverse that thing, right? Don't let your son be on the side of the room with all the girls. You know, the other day we had a brother like, look, tell them boys to go on the other side of the room, right? Don't let them do that kind of stuff. Don't let your son put your heels on and you think it's funny. Don't let him do that. Don't let him be around, walking around with his wrist like this or his hand on his hip or whatever. Don't let your sons do that. And guess what you need to do? You need to be looking for a husband. You need to be trying to find you a husband to be able to raise your sons to be a man and not emotional. All right? So guess what? That's the show for today. All praise to the Most High. I was able to fill in for the mighty Captain Gedaliah. Right now, they're on the other side of the earth doing what the scriptures say. Matter of fact, give me that scripture. Give me Matthew 24. Matthew 24 and verse 14.
Matthew chapter 24 and verse 14.
Go ahead.
And this gospel of the kingdom shall be preached in all the world.
Preach where?
In all the world.
And that's what we do here at Israel United in Christ. We don't just teach in our backyard. We don't just teach online, Facebook, and stuff like that. We teach all over the world. And guess what? Right now, Ghana is getting this word. We teach all over the world. Keep reading.
And this gospel of the kingdom shall be preached in all the world.
Go ahead.
For a witness unto all nations.
For a witness to all nations. We're going to bring this truth everywhere to all nations. If we ain't there yet, don't worry. We'll be there soon. Go ahead.
And then shall the end come.
Because that's what we want. We want to escape the plantation. We want the end to come and for the other nations' rulership to end and for our rulership to begin. All right, so all praise to the Most High. I'm Captain Yadin, IUIC Birmingham. This is Escaping the Plantation 2.0. All right, and with that, we're going to say shalom, y'all.
Shalom. We used to scream black power while Heron was pushed. But at the end of the day, nothing's in vain. IUIC has been given a vision. The tents of Judah has risen. Many has attempted the mission, minor murmuring, omitting, and missing the mark. Just reading that he had the flame of fire in his eyes gave us the spark. We on Paul's mission. We out on the road, purple and gold, from Mexico, Cuba, Haiti, Ghana, Sierra Leone. 144,000 boots banging, concrete crackling. These are our men repented at heart. The scriptures is proof. IUIC, we deliver the truth.